Of Portius, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, Lithia, who have been chosen according to the foreknowledge of God the Father through the sanctifying work of the Holy Spirit, to be obedient to Jesus Christ and sprinkled with his blood. Grace and peace be yours in abundance. Praise to the God and the Father of our God. Praise to the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercies, he has given us new birth in a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade. This inheritance is kept in heaven for you, who through faith are shielded by God's power until the coming of salvation that is ready to be revealed in the last time. In all this, you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while you may have had to suffer in grief, in all kinds of trials. These have come so that the proven genuineness of your faith, your greater worth than gold, which perishes, though refined by fire, may result in praise, glory, and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Though you have not seen him, you love him. Though you do not see him now, you may believe in him and are filled with an inexpressible, glorious joy, for you are receiving the end result of your faith, the salvation of your souls. Concerning this salvation, the prophets who spoke of the grace that was to come to you searched intently with the greatest care, trying to find out the time and the circumstances to which the Spirit of God in them was pointing when he predicted the sufferings of the Messiah, the glories that would follow. It was revealed to them that they were not serving themselves, but you. When they spoke of things that now being told you by those who have preached the gospel to you by the Holy Spirit sent from heaven. Even angels long to look into these things. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We were reading the scriptures from 1 Peter chapter 1 to 12. And this morning as we gather, praise the Lord, we pray the Holy Spirit would lead us to this consciousness, to the sensitivity of our salvation, knowing that those also who are ahead of us were longing, praise the Lord, they were longing for this inheritance. Those also who are ahead, they saw it in visions, they saw it in their dreams, to be where we are, to have this inheritance of this faith, of believing in Jesus Christ. Though you have not seen him, though he's not here right now, you believe and you have a joy. Praise the Lord. So as we enter into his presence, may the Holy Spirit reveal to us this knowledge. May the Holy Spirit open our eyes of understanding. May the Holy Spirit sensitize even our children. May the Holy Spirit cause there to be an unction,
to worship, hallelujah. The ones who went ahead of us were longing. They were longing for what we have. They were longing for this faith. They were longing for the Holy Spirit. May we be connected today. May we be connected so we may bring to birth, bring to manifestation the revelation to those ones who are also in darkness. Praise the Lord. So there is a greater work for us. Oh yes, as we stay in the presence of God, as we get equipped in the presence of the Holy Spirit, for our eyes to be open, because there's more. There's a lot more in the Holy Spirit. There's a lot more in the kingdom that we do not have. And we need that. We need it in the work that we have in these hours. So as the Spirit of God would lead you in these hours that He's given us, because this is a gift, to be in the hearing of the Word of God, to be in the hearing, to inherit, hallelujah, in this flesh. It is a gift from God. So I pray today that you forget about everything else. Forget about all those other things, hallelujah, because they are already yours, hallelujah. As you seek Him first, His kingdom, His righteousness, they shall follow you. Those things shall be added. There'll be bonus. Hallelujah. But let's seek Him first this morning. Shoot your hands to the Lord this morning. Just surrender to God this morning. Let your heart be open. Let your mind receive the Spirit of God this day in the name of Jesus. We come to pray, Lord, tonight, this morning, this afternoon, that God, in the name of Jesus Christ, that you open our hearts, you open our minds, you open our passion, you open your revelation to us. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, we invite you in our hearts. We invite you in this altar. This is your altar, oh God. You desire to use it for your kingdom. You desire to use each and every person here this day, oh God. There may be, oh Father, your agents here on earth. You desire your work to be an inheritance for all. And we pray that only the Holy Spirit is the only one who can break every seal, who can break every captivity, who can cause our minds to be transformed, to be transfigured to the image and the glory of your kingdom. We surrender all. Oh, come on, people of God, open your mouth to God.
embrace the presence of God. Embrace Him, embrace Him. Oh, forget about yourself. Forget about yourself. Forget about yourself. And consecrate upon the Holy Spirit. He wants to do something new. He wants to renew you. He wants to renew your family. He wants to renew your children. He wants to renew your country. He wants to renew you. He wants to renew us. It's your turning aside. We bathe in the presence of the Holy Spirit this morning.
Thank you. Thank you. smile for the Lord. Let's smile for the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's smile for the Lord. Because this morning we are about to break the wall of Jericho. Hallelujah. We are about to break the wall of Jericho today. With your praise. All you gotta do is praise. Praise the way out. Praise the way out. Praise the way out. I don't care about your problem. I don't care about your situation. All you have to do is just praise your way out. Hallelujah. Are you ready to praise your way out? Tell your neighbor there's no better place. Tell your neighbor, give me some space. Give me some space. It's time to praise my God.
Yeah. Kings, Lord of Lords, I worship you. Sing holy.
Lord of Lords, I worship you. up and lift the name of the high, Lord. High, high is your name. Lord is your name. We glorify your name this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. Thank you because you are our God. We worship you this morning. We glorify your name this morning. Mighty is your name and worthy is your name. Thank you, Lord of God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for another day you have given unto us. Thank you, dear Father, for the gift of life. Thank you, dear Father, for the bread who sustains life. We thank you, dear Father, for all your creation. We thank you for another day you have provided unto us this morning. That God, we may gather and worship you. We glorify your name. You deserve the praise and honor. You deserve all the adoration. You deserve all the glory. We have for ourselves this morning. We magnify your name this morning. We glorify your name this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Holy, holy is your name. Holy, holy is your name. We worship you this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, King of Kings. We glorify your name. Thank you. Tunakushukuru, tunakuabudu, tunalinua jina lako takatifu. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you for who you are. Thank you, dear Father, for salvation. Thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross. Thank you, dear Father, for paying for our sins. Thank you, Jesus, because you have watched over us, dear Redeemer. Worship you and glorify your name. Tunakuabudu na kukushukuru. Asante Mungu, asante Mungu. Receive all the glory and honor. Receive all the adoration, mighty Lord. Receive all the adoration this morning. Receive all the glory this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for being with us all day that we go, dear Father. Even as we pray, oh dear Father. Even as we continue to fast, dear Father. You have been with us, dear Redeemer. You have walked with us, dear Father. We have seen you hold our hands, dear Redeemer. We have seen you work miracles, dear Father. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. Thank you even for the new year you have given unto us. We receive it in thanksgiving, dear Father. Thank you for being with us, dear Redeemer. Thank you for sustaining our life, dear Father. Irrespective of many things which has happened, dear Father. The COVID issue, dear Father. But God, you have preserved us, oh Lord. You have preserved us, dear Father. Receive all the glory this morning. Receive all the adoration this morning. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Continue to listen to worship the Lord. Continue to give thanks to the Lord. There is so much you can give thanks to the Lord for this year. For all what he has done for you. For all what he has done for your family. For all what he has done for your country. For all that he has done for your colleagues. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. Receive all the glory and honor. Receive all the adoration this morning. We glorify your name. Thank you, Lord. As a sanctuary, as a church, dear Father, there's so much I can give you thanks for. As a ministry, dear Father, we have seen you. As individuals, dear Father, we have witnessed your presence in our lives. As families, dear Redeemer, you have walked with us. Receive all the honor. Receive all the adoration this morning. You deserve our thanks. You deserve our worship, dear Father. Worship. We have ourselves this morning and we glorify your holy name. Thank you, Jesus, this morning. Thank you, Redeemer, this morning. Thank you for being with us through the way. Thank you, dear Father, for your blessing. Thank you for giving us life. Thank you for blessing our children. Thank you for blessing our ministers, O Lord. Those who we have not been this time, O dear Father. Thank you, dear Father. You have blessed us, dear Redeemer. Receive for the adoration. Receive for the honor this morning. We worship you. Glorify your holy name. Thank you, dear Father. We want to pray that this year you will be with us, dear Redeemer. There is much you have planned for us, oh dear God. We know you have a plan for us. Irrespective of the snares that the devil might put in our lives, dear Father. We will break the snares of the enemy. Which the snares which the devil might be putting in this year upon our children, upon our lives. We want to come against them this morning. We want to break them and destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus.
that this year, dear Redeemer, we will witness your presence in our lives. You walk with us, dear Father. You guide us and protect us. You shield us from the evil one. You continue to bless us this evening and this year, oh dear Father. We are waiting until you this year, dear Father. We destroy the work of the enemy. We destroy the work of the evil one. Who comes to destroy? Who comes to steal and destroy? Who comes to kill, dear Father? What you have put in our eyes, dear Father? Upon our children, dear Father. Upon the ministry, dear Redeemer. We're going to break all the plans of the enemy. We're going to break the plans of the evil one. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, dear Father, that this year, dear Redeemer, you're going to walk with us, oh God. You're going to bless us, oh dear Father. You're going to sustain our families, dear Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. You're going to hold us together, dear Redeemer. You're going to continue to bless us in the name of Jesus. Even as a ministry, dear Father, we're going to pray that God, you continue to walk with us, dear Father. You're going to bless us, oh Lord, dear Lord, as we increase, oh Lord, as we increase spiritually, dear Father, as we increase even in numbers, dear Lord. We pray that God, you guide us, oh Lord, continue to walk with us. Continue to hold us, dear Father. We surrender unto you this morning. We surrender unto you this morning. We continue, dear Father, to desire to walk in your presence, to desire to walk in your arms, to desire to walk in your footsteps, dear Father, because you are God, O Lord. We worship and glorify your name. We thank you this morning. Continue to bless the men of this fellowship. Continue to bless all the ministries in this fellowship. The pastoral ministry, dear Redeemer. The men of fellowship, dear Father. The women of breakthrough, dear Father. The youth and the children. Continue to bless them, dear Father. Continue to hold us together, dear Redeemer. As a ministry in the name of Jesus. We bless your name this morning. And we glorify your holy name, dear Father. We're going to pray for our country, dear Father. We're going to pray for this land of America in the mighty name of Jesus. We're going to come against the work of the evil ones. We're going to come against the work of the enemy, dear Father. We're going to speak the word of God in this country in the name of Jesus. From the highest office, oh dear Lord, to the lowest office, dear Father. We pray that the readers may seek your counsel, dear Father. Even as they make decisions, all the arms of government, we're going to pray for your blessing, dear Father. Continue to bless them, dear Father. Even as they govern, because you have given them authority, which come from you, dear Father. We pray for them from the west to the east, to the south, to the north. We're going to cover this land in the blood of Jesus. We're going to speak blessing, dear Father, in this land, oh Lord. That God, you may continue even to increase us as we serve you, dear Father. Even our work, oh dear Father, you bless the work of our hands, dear Father, because you are God, dear Father. We're going to pray for the world, all countries, dear Father, in this world, from west to east, from south to north, dear Father, where there is issues, where there is bloodshed, where there is calamities, dear Father, may you face those who are there, dear Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. We speak blessing, dear Father, upon our heart, dear Father, because you are God. We worship you this morning. We thank you for this service. We are covered and committed unto your holy hand, dear Father. Because you brought us in this sanctuary with a purpose, dear Lord. That God, we may speak unto you. That God, you may hear your word. Because your word is like a double-edged sword, dear Lord. Which comes, dear Father, and cut through bones, dear Lord. Your word rebukes and teaches. Your word, dear Father, trains. Your word encourages, dear Lord. This morning we are waiting unto you. That God, you're going to speak unto us, dear Father. Our hearts will be receptive of your word. And more so, we continue to walk us, your word, dear Lord. Continue to guide us even as we remain your fine hand.